Hey guys, we're back again for He Lived, Heaven's Live Video Devotional. Tonight, we've got a great story for you guys. We're going to be reading from the book of Daniel. That's where the word on the street is. Daniel chapter 3, and we're going to read verses 17 and 18. Let me give you just a couple of seconds to get there. I would say when you get there, say amen, but I can't hear you. All right, so hoping you got it now. The Bible says, we're kind of picking up the story in the middle, so I'll explain. It says, if it be so, our God whom we serve is able to deliver us from the burning fiery furnace. And he will deliver us out of thine hands, O king. But if not, be it known unto thee, O king, that we will not serve thy gods, nor worship the golden image which thou hast set up. Now let me just give you a little background here as to what's going on, because we did pick up the story right in the middle. So Daniel had a couple friends, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, and they were the princes of a province that Nebuchadnezzar the king had. And so Nebuchadnezzar had built this huge golden image, and when the bells or the horns and the trumpets rang, he wanted everyone to just bow down to this image. But of course, God in the Ten Commandments says, you shall have no other gods before me. So they knew that this would go completely against God's law. And when you love God, you keep his commandments. And so the trumpets went, the bells went, everything went off, and everyone around them is bowing except these three men. And Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego were standing up. And so the king was so upset, he said, I'm going to ring this thing one more time and let you give you the opportunity to bow. But they did not bow. And he said, well, we're going to throw you in the fiery furnace. Now, if that sounds like anything fun to you, I'm not quite sure what's wrong. But that doesn't sound like a fun place to me. Because I live in New York, and it doesn't get too hot. But when it gets to about 90 degrees, 95, with all that humidity, I'm just like, whew, I can't take it no more, God. Please, get me back to 70. But King Nebuchadnezzar decided to raise the temperature a couple times higher than what it normally is. So, in my mind, if something's 350 degrees at 450 degrees, it still feels the same to me. It still feels hot. So, he threw them in this hot, fiery furnace. He had to bind them with rope, and he had to get these big, strong guys to throw them in there. And if you continue reading the story in the Bible, it says that the men that threw them in, the fire was so hot that it killed them. That's crazy. So just to continue. So they're in there, and you would expect that if the heat of the fire is killing the people that are throwing them in there, then they shouldn't last too long in the fire either, right? Well, wrong. What you forgot is that they had God on their side, and God will never leave you or forsake you. So while they're in the fire, or while you're in the midst of your tough situation, God is right there with you. Because if we go back into the word, we see that in verse 24, it says, then King Nebuchadnezzar the king was astonished and rose up in haste and spake and said unto his councilmen, did not we cast three men bound into the midst of the fire? And they answered and said, king, true, O king. He answered and said, lo, I see four men loose, walking in the midst of the fire, and they have no hurt. And the form of the fourth is like the Son of God. Hallelujah, hallelujah. And so here they are in the midst of their pressure situation. And here you might be in the midst of some tough situation that you're wondering, God, oh God, why did you put me here? Why am I in this tough jam? I thought this Christian journey would be easy. But let's not forget that God does have the power to deliver you out of any situation. And even if he doesn't, he'll still be with you. And that's precisely what we see here. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego got thrown into what everyone thought was sure death. But with God, God loves to show up and show out. And that's exactly what he did here. He came through, and if you read carefully, you realize that the only thing that got burned on them or burned off were the ropes that were binding them. And so God threw them in a tough situation, burnt off the things that were holding them bound, and they were walking around free with him. And the fourth figure, King Nebuchadnezzar said, looked like the Son of Man. So truly, we know that even when we're going through these tough situations, God is right there with us, oftentimes holding our hands, carrying us, being that faithful Father that the Bible describes him to be to us. So today I encourage you, please, if God is putting you through something tough, it's okay to question him, but don't ever doubt his presence because he's right there with you. Don't ever doubt his power because he can take you out of any situation. But even if he doesn't, he is still there holding your hand and taking you through. And at the end of it, you'll come out stronger, loosed of anything that was binding you, and ready to serve him and change the lives of people around you. Because later on in the chapter, King Nebuchadnezzar said, "Truly, the God of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego is the one true God."